Kyle Bradshaw from Chaparral Motorsports here, and today we're going to take you down into our tire pit, and we're going to show you a dismount and a full mount of this brand new tire. Now, when you first get the tires to your doorstep, it is imperative that you take the time to take a look at the tire before you take it to the shop or into your garage to mount it. A couple of the key things you want to take a look at. Number one, is the bead of the tire completely intact? Does it look good? Are there any frays in it or cuts? Because those are things that can cause issues when doing your mount up. Another thing you're going to want to check first off is the tire size. Is it the right size tire for the tire you're replacing? For example, this tire here is a 140/90/15. You need to make sure that the tire on the bike is exactly the same. The most important number when swapping out your tire is going to be that last number there, in this case, the 15. It's that rim diameter number that is the most important number. That's the number that cannot change. If it's a 15-inch rim, it needs a 15-inch tire. Now, the aspect ratio can change. If you have a 140, you can go a 130 or potentially a 150, but again, that 15-inch tire size is the dimension that cannot change. So make sure that that is the same as the one on your bike, and you'll be good to go. The next thing you really want to take a look at is the directional arrow. Make sure that the tire, as it sits on your motorcycle, is mounted in the correct direction. You'd be amazed at how many tires come to our shop, and the tire is actually mounted backwards on the wheel from whoever did the previous installation. It's really sad, but it happens quite a bit. What I like to do is I like to take a piece of masking tape or duct tape or something and put that on the rim and draw an arrow on the rim. That way, when you remove the tire from the wheel, you know exactly the direction the new tire needs to go back on. Another thing to take a look at is the balance dot. There's a colored circle or dot on the tire somewhere if the tire is not 100% perfectly balanced. If it is, there won't be a dot and you don't need to worry about it. But if there is a colored dot on the tire, that dot needs to go at the valve stem. So make sure that after you get the tire mounted up, that you double check to make sure that that dot is where that valve stem is. What we're gonna do now, super exciting, we're gonna take this tire down into our tire mount balance bay, and Joe is gonna give us a hand doing a professional install on this particular tire on a real wheel. The first step in the mounting process is the dismount, of course. So what you're gonna do is remove the wheel from the motorcycle. You're gonna remove the valve cap, remove the valve core, and then remove, if it's a tubeless or if it's a tube tire, there's going to be a nut holding the valve stem in place. You go ahead and remove that as well. Now the tire will have no air in it. The next step is to break the bead. You're going to step up either to your tire machine or you're going to use a Motion Pro bead breaker. There's lots of different ways to break the bead, but that's going to be your next step. Once the bead's broken, you're going to use either your tire machine or a tire iron to carefully lift the bead of the tire out, up, and over the rim. Once you've gotten the tire up and over the rim all the way around, you need to remove the tube, if it's a tube tire. So removing the tube, you're going to pull it all the way around. You're going to pull the valve stem out. If it's tubeless, you go straight to the next step. So here we're at the halfway point. Joe is going to make sure that this tire sits into the drop center when he pushes this over. That's going to allow this smaller diameter here to fit over the larger diameter of the rim. So again, the drop center right down here in the bottom, you're going to see him massaging this tire to get both of these beads into that drop center so we can get this over the much larger wheel. Once you've verified that the tire is the correct tire and that the direction of the tire is appropriate for how you have the rim laying, it's now time to insert the tire onto the rim. So the way I like to do is I like to push the tire onto the base of the rim to begin with and then start working that bead up and over the backside of the rim. Again, that drop center is extremely important. Once that's done, we're going to go ahead and insert our tube in a tube tire. For a tubeless tire, you just go ahead and skip to the point where we're going to set that top part of the bead into the rim. So we're going to push down here towards the bottom, work your way up, and you're going to end up with a spot at basically 9 o'clock and 3 o'clock. That's going to be the last part of the tire that you need to be able to spoon or machine onto the rim. This is where it is imperative that you get both the bottom bead and the top bead squished down, pushed into that drop center. It's almost an inch of material that you need to be able to move up and over the rim, with the rim being larger than that initial diameter of the tire. So a lot of work needs to be put, or care needs to be taken, to make sure that that bead, both of them, are in the drop center before you do that final push. Now I'm stressing this so much because so many times you see people with torn beads or bent rims, and that is a horrible situation. With a tire, you might lose 100, 200 bucks, 300 bucks at the most on a tire if you ruin a bead. But if you bend your rim, that could be thousands of dollars of damage. And there you have it. Joe has just shown us how a professional tire dismount and mount is done here at Chaparral Motorsports. Thank you for watching, and please remember to like and subscribe to these so you get all of our future videos, one of those being our tire balance video. We're going to show you how to not only balance here at the shop, but balance at home on your own balancer. I'm Kyle Bradshaw. Until next time, take care and ride safe.